Hey everyone, it's nice to have you back. In case you don't know me, I'm Charlotte and I live in Bosnia to study dentistry. I'm actually German and I moved there about 3 years ago. So I take a lot of trips, I live there, I've seen a lot. And I thought I'd take you along to my trip through Neum and passing by Mostar just to see the skywalk that has just newly opened. Today I'm filming from home. And I thought because the weather is amazing, I'd take you outside. So if there's going to be car sounds, animal sounds, nature, well, I thought, let's embrace it, have a good time, and let me tell you everything. So we drove down past Mostar to get to the ocean. And you could see a lot of construction because there's a lot of roads being built. We were kind of unlucky because there's just one route from Sarajevo to Neum. Well, the shortest route. I'm sure there's a land route somewhere else that's going to take you 7 to 8 hours as well. But this route was supposed to take you 4 hours. And so we took it. And we knew it's going to take a bit longer. There's going to be traffic. There's going to be something. And of course there was. We'll be driving across this beautiful lakes and passing these, passing by these rivers. It's just, the scenery was just fantastic. We were a bit unlucky with the weather, but it was still warm, so we enjoyed the ride. You got a few meters of highway, and then you got land streets again, and you got a lot of country roads, like gravel roads as well, and that was the official way because they were during construction. And then you pass through these modern tunnels that you'd expect in the center of Europe, so European Union, because we're not, like, Bosnia's not part of the European Union, and you'd see this high-tech tunnel and you'd just be so impressed, and that you see all these new potentials happening because more roads, more connections, easy to get places. It's going to be amazing for Bosnia. So we drove there and passed these forests. It was beautiful. It's just driving there is worth it. So we finally got to Neum in the evening, and it was spectacular. It was raining all day, and the sky cleared to the most beautiful sunset, which was just, we were so lucky. And then we went for food, and it was perfect evening, but we were just exhausted from driving all day. And we woke up early the next morning. It was beautiful weather, so we decided, okay, let's explore now. And we went to the ocean, and it was crystal clear water. You could see the rock. It had like a few small beaches. I'm saying beaches because they're rock beaches. They're not the classical sand beaches that you would expect or know. Nonetheless, beautiful. And we wanted to go swimming there, but then we saw that there's this tongue basically leading out that when you're in Neum you can look upon, and it's basically nature. But we saw on Google Maps that there were some houses, so we thought, how about we go there to explore, to go into the water there, because that is a very unique place to go swimming and less people, because on the small beaches there were obviously people, there were all houses. It was very pretty, and you could see like people had their houses, they took care of, obviously some older buildings too, but nothing compared to Sarajevo old buildings. We looked at the ocean, and then we went into the car and we drove along this small tongue of land, all obviously squished between Croatia, and we went to see the ocean from there. And we had this beautiful gravel path that we took, and from that path on we went to like the small village. So we parked someone there and just walked down. We had no idea if we were allowed to walk there or not, and we were just hoping we wouldn't get in trouble. So we went there and we found this tiny fisher village. You can't even call it a village because it was just a few houses, and it was so beautiful, and there were hardly any people. So we decided to walk along there and to maybe see if we can find a more discreet place to go swimming, which we did find. And we went for a swim, and then there was this old lady who's not amused about us being there, so she basically shooshed us away. But it was perfect. The water was so clear. So we dipped into the Adriatic Sea, which is part of the Mediterranean Sea, which was just so cold. It takes some time for water to to warm up, but it was so worth it. It was so beautiful. We drove back on the way back, still on that land tongue, and we went to the other side, and there we could look onto the Croatian land. We could see the bridge from Croatia's one side to the other being built. It's a huge bridge, which was very impressive. And there was this tiny beach club, which was super cool, and which was pretty new, and they were still building it. And then we decided, okay, we're going to do one more thing. We thought we'd go and explore the new skywalk, which I read cost 20,000 euros to make, which is not that expensive if you think about the cost of the glass alone. But it's not so high, it's not that long, but it's beautiful. We had the most amazing view over Mostar, and Mostar already is just beautiful. I mean, that's an entire different story, Mostar. But it's not the only beautiful place in Bosnia. I always think it's so sad when I see these videos just being like, Mostar is the most beautiful place. And it's like, yeah, Mostar is amazing. But have you seen the rest of Bosnia? It's like, oh my God, it's beautiful. Anyways, I'm going on a tangent. But basically, when we went to this skywalk, you had to drive up the mountain from Mostar. And you basically, you're just driving up on this road for one car, and there's no railing on the side, and it goes down pretty steep. So I was just like, don't focus on that. Like, I'm not scared of heights, but I did not feel safe there. So we drove up, and we finally got to the top, because it's very interesting. Basically, it goes up, and then it goes, like, it goes down on some sides, but if you drive further up, you actually get to a plateau where there's lots of houses. Anyways, back to the skywalk. So we were there, and we saw these horses, and we followed them a bit because it was just beautiful and scenic. And then we went to the skywalk, and it was spectacular. It was very windy that day, so that might have contributed to me not enjoying it as much, but it was just spectacular. Just the view, it was just perfect. I would recommend anyone who wants to have an amazing view over Mostar to go. I mean, if you go Mostar, just look at that too. It has these lines that you take, and then you go down. I forgot the name. Anyways, it has one of those, and it's pretty cool. I still have to do that, so I have a long bucket list of things I want to do in Bosnia, and I will try and record them all for you. Anyways, so we were up there. We drove a bit higher to look at the windmills, and then we found, like, there were lots of small houses everywhere with lots of sheep, and it looked so idyllic. And that was all just at Mostar. It's like just not even far away from it. However, we then had to go back. Since at 9, you had to be back indoors due to the COVID. We had to go back, and back it was the same kind of deal, because at Mostar, like after Mostar, before, I'm not quite sure right now. But there, again, there was the same traffic, because so we got home half an hour before we were supposed to be indoors, and we were just exhausted from it, the beautiful day. And I would highly recommend anyone who wants to see Mostar and who wants to see Neum to check out not just like the classical bridge, but also go into the skywalk. Anyone who wants to visit Neum to go and enjoy it. It's beautiful. And don't just go to Neum. Go to the land tongue. I don't know what it's called, like the small piece of land, because it's so worth it. It's so worth it. It's just nature is still completely preserved there. It's very interesting because you still have the Croatian checkered symbol on the road, basically what you see from the other side. That is very typical to find that throughout Bosnia, the borders between Croatian Bosnia, Serbian Bosnia, Bosnian Bosnia. You know, it's a bit complicated, the situation, but it's very cool, and it's a very relaxed place. And if you go to Bosnia and you wanna see all its diversity, there's so much more, so much more. And I hope you come and visit, because I've fallen in love with this country, and I think everyone who gives it a chance to visit it will fall in love with it too. So I also recorded driving from one side of Bosnian coastline to the other. So from one Croatian border bordering Bosnia to the other side. And it's pretty cool because you can actually see what to expect, like how Neum looks, the roads, and then you get a small glimpse, I guess, of the border starting. And you can also understand some of the beauty, like just driving that small piece of road. Also, a small correction. You don't say Neum, you say Neum. Sorry for everyone who speaks Bosnian and had to suffer through that. So I hope to see you next time. Bye. Don't forget to like and subscribe. See you next time.